Oh, another day done. So yesterday felt like a little bit of a rarity. I actually had a good gym session. And I'm starting to kind of accept where my bench is at the moment and enjoying it for what it is. So I managed to get up to 92.5 kilos for a single. Obviously not very impressive, but I am weirdly enjoying that process at the moment. And what I'm enjoying is the fact that, first of all, obviously I'm not getting injured with my sessions, but also enjoying just like the challenge of going into each session and actually doing the proper mobility, the proper warm-ups. And for me, that's a little bit of a challenge. And I think that's something that I kind of neglected before, when I would have more recurring injuries. So I'm enjoying going in, doing what I need to do on the bench at the moment. But obviously the big highlight of yesterday's session was the new SSB personal best, getting 232.5 kilos on that. And it felt anticlimactically easy. I haven't really looked through the rest of the program. I don't really know how much we're going to look to progress the SSB, but I genuinely feel at the moment I'm good for 240, maybe even more than that, which is kind of mad because around about a year ago I failed 240, and I feel like it would actually be relatively comfortable now. And it's such a good movement, the SSB. I definitely find it has good carryover, not just for squats, but also for deadlifts as well. So I really enjoy doing that movement. And what I'm enjoying most of all is the fact that I don't have to pause the reps, because I've been doing so many pause SSB reps recently, that it's nice to actually just do a normal squat. But also what I was really happy about was the fact that my adductor didn't play up, because obviously last week I was having a few issues with my adductor. But that didn't really, no, I couldn't feel it at all when I was squatting yesterday. So yeah, good positive signs ahead. Hopefully I can continue like that for the rest of the week. I think what I can put down the adductor stuff to is I'm just being a lot more mobile at the moment. So I'm getting out for more walks. I managed to do 11,000 steps on Sunday, and just really trying to hit that average of 5,000 steps for the week. And I've been pretty good with that recently, and I think that has really contributed to just generally being more mobile, moving around, and just allowing for better recovery.
Concentric deadlifts. They are literally the most brutal form of variation of deadlift I've ever done. It's 5 seconds up, but the whole point is just maintaining my position as much as possible. I have found that when I fail in deadlift, it's often because I lose positioning, so I'm really grading that, but they're absolutely humbling.
So, if you're thinking about giving those concentric deadlifts a go, fair warning, it's probably going to put your blood pressure into the ceiling, but luckily, I've got a little solution which is scientifically proven to lower that blood pressure. Do you want to know what it is? Come here, I'll whisper it to you. And that is, of course,
and the guy
go to the pub. So I don't know exactly how much that's backed by science, but I'm sticking with it. So here with the cousin and the uncle. The uncle has just informed me he wants to say a little piece for the YouTubes.
Okay, I'd just like to say how much I admire Matt as a gym person, but I do want people to know that I trained him when he was younger.
When we were both benching, what, 60 kilos?
No, Matt once said 62. To me, God, I wish I could bench press as much as you. The words came out.
What was it?
God, I wish I could bench press as much as you.
I did once say that. And here we are now. I could probably do what, double what you do now?
Oh my God, more than, Matt, more than double. It's like quadruple.
I'll give you that fiver later. The only annoying thing is, after that football result, my blood pressure is right back up again. And for any of you that are wondering, no, I didn't have a pint. I had a lemonade and a Diet Coke. Obviously, still sticking to my 6 months of no drinking. But yeah, it's the first time I've actually been to the pub since January. So it was going to be a little bit of a test as to whether I was going to drink or not, but stuck to it.
Okay, so welcome to the last training session of the week. Just finished squats, worked up to 210 for a triple. Felt really easy 2 weeks ago. I went for 207.5 for a triple and I felt my adductor strain a little bit, so luckily this time round there's no issues there. That's what I was a little bit worried about going into today's session. Also did bench, worked up to 95 kilos, but my camera decided to have a little malfunction and didn't film that, but not that it's that exciting to film anyway. But just finishing off the session now, doing some dips, some lat pull downs, some just general fluff work, and then get home.
So I'm not going to lie, I'm actually really shattered. It's been a really good week of training, but I'm just absolutely exhausted. Obviously the highlight being the 232.5 kilo on Monday, a new personal best. I feel very confident that I'm actually going to break that again fairly soon because it just felt quite easy, to be honest. So I think there is another PB in the tank very soon. Another positive is I didn't get a migraine on Wednesday when I did the concentric deadlift like I did 2 weeks previously, and today when I squatted 210 kilos for a triple, my adductor also stayed in one piece. So it sounds very negative that I'm listing off the fact that I didn't injure myself as positives, but I've just had such rotten luck with my injuries over the last few months that I'm happy to celebrate a week when I haven't injured myself, and that is what I've done this week. And to be honest, I think I can put it down to the fact that I am just putting a lot more focus into my rest and my recovery. I've noticed on my spreadsheet that I've put together since the beginning of the year that this week I have done a lot more movement. So obviously I'm tracking my steps at the moment just to see how much movement I'm doing. And I've been aiming for an average of 5,000 steps a day. And this week I've actually managed to do that. So I'm getting a lot more movement in, which is obviously going to aid with my recovery. And I think that's probably why this week I haven't hurt myself. I've also upped my calories a little bit this week by adding in a couple of cheat meals. So that's probably helped as well, just having a little bit more energy and a lot more energy to use into the gym. Yesterday I went to TGI Fridays and had a humongous burger, which was absolutely amazing. And I had a dessert. So that was like my first proper cheat meal that I've had since the beginning of the year. So I think that really helped today going in the gym, because I did feel like I had a lot of energy and squats just felt really good. So I'm trying to be clever with things like my nutrition. I don't want to be having obviously too many calories too often, because I don't want to just balloon up and get really big. I'm quite happy to sort of maintain my calories throughout the week, and then when I know I've got a bit more of a bigger session, up those a little bit. So just being a little bit smart with how I actually count and track my calories, and obviously the same with my movement, just making sure that I'm moving as much as I can, but not moving too much the day before I have a big session. Like I'm not going to go and do a massive amount of walking tomorrow. I am going out for a walk tomorrow, but I don't want to do too much that it kind of affects deadlifts the next day. So I'm just trying to be a little bit smart with my recovery and my nutrition, and so far it seems to be working. Right then, I don't really have much more to talk about really. It's been a pretty good week of training. I am feeling a little bit stressed, I'm not gonna lie. That is one thing that I have noticed this week, just mainly with like work, but also because I'm back at uni for my second year now, and the module we're doing at the moment is very tough. We're doing neurophysiotherapy, so there's a lot of words, a lot of Latin words that I just don't know what they mean, and I've got an exam in a month, so that's kind of on the forefront of my mind at the moment, along with training. Obviously training is always there, but I do need to balance it out a little bit. There are different kinds of stresses. Obviously the gym is a sort of physical stress, uni and work is that mental stress, and stress is stress at the end of the day. So if it builds up too much, that can lead to burnout, and I don't want to be doing that. So I need to make sure that I am balancing the two or the three of those things a little bit more. But I feel like I'm managing it at the moment. I feel like I'm in a good place. And stress isn't always a bad thing, because that can be a sign that you're progressing and you're doing things which make you a little bit uncomfortable, which I think is actually quite a good thing, because that sort of shows that you are developing and progressing as a person. So yeah, I don't mind at the moment the stress levels that I'm at, but I am just recognizing that I am a little bit stressed at the moment. So I need to keep an eye on it, just balance things out and make sure it doesn't get too much. Anyway, guys, I'm going to go and crash and get an early night because, like I say, I'm absolutely shattered. But I hope you have enjoyed the video as always. Please leave it a like if you have enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're new. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Peace.